Abba Saar, Alistair Edwards, Irvin Boban, Hassan Miskam, Nasser Yusuf, and many more great names brought Johor to greater heights by winning the double in 1991. Right after those glory days, Johor football went downhill. No progress was made to bring Johor back to her heyday. Everything changed when His Royal Highness Brigadier General Tunku Ismail, the Crown Prince of Johor, took charge of the Johor Football Association in 2013.
There's no more off the record. You want to know something about saya, pelaburan pasukan ke apa-apa saja, feel free to tell, ask me. Oleh kerana saya diamanahkan jaga pasukan bola sepak Negeri Johor. Persatuan Bola Sepak Negeri Johor adalah Persatuan Bola Sepak Rakyat Negeri Johor.
You tell me now, where can you have a president of a football association standing in front of his fans and give the right to the fans untuk tanya apa saja they want?
The ideas and the effort put in by the Crown Prince of Johor, who is also the royal patron for the Johor Football Association, continued with the full refurbishment of the Tan Sri Dato' Haji Hassan Yunus Larkin Stadium, which was once abandoned by football fans and now stands tall, proud and mighty. The furniture and fittings are now on par with some of the greatest stadiums in Europe. World-class imports like Pablo Aimar and Daniel Gueza joining the team that was rebranded with a new name, Johor Darul Takzim. The first year of transformation didn't go so well for JDT as they finished third in the 2013 Malaysia Super League and lost in the 2013 FA Cup Finals, which was a major blow for the team. But that was not the end. JDT continued to move forward, and the results now speak for themselves. The success achieved by the team was not easily obtained. Every moment of sadness and joy was truly a labor of love. Holding to the saying, a sweet success starts with a dream. This team successfully made that dream a reality. JDT's success and glory wouldn't have happened without all the sponsors who have contributed in more ways than one with the transformation since 2013. With all their support and contributions, it is what JDT has become today. Together with the media, with their ample coverage and extensive exposure, made JDT a name that stands proud amongst all Malaysian football clubs. A million thanks to all of you who still believe in the vision of His Royal Highness, the Crown Prince of Johor and the team. Congratulations and thank you once again.